Hey guys, I've been playing a ton of Grand Blue Fantasy Relink recently, and amongst the characters I've built, Io is my favorite at the moment. I've learned a few things along the way and want to share them with everyone, so welcome to my guide to Io. For her auto attacks, there's not really much to note. It's a standard three-hit combo, exactly the same in the air, and the alternate fire in the air is an attack that slams straight down. For her charged attacks, you hold down your attack button, and it shoots an empowered auto that gives you a Mystic Vortex stack to both speed up and increase your Stargaze level. Stargaze is an extremely strong nuke with a very long cast time. For this reason, it should generally only be quick casted, meaning immediately following your charged attack or skills that generated Mystic Vortex. Stargaze's long ending animation can and should be negated by dodging. This will help you keep you mobile in fights, as well as increasing your damage output. Of her 8 spells, these 5 grant Mystic Vortex stacks, so let's start with these. Freeze dashes you back and shoots 5 bolts at the target. If you're too close to a wall or object, some of the bolts will collide with it and not reach the target, but generally, because this is a low damage skill that's mainly used for Mystic Vortex, I tend to not worry about that. Fire is a quick spell that deals good damage and applies a minus 10% defense debuff on hit. Fire does 1 to 3 hits depending on your distance from the target. The first hit requires you to be in melee range, the second mid-range, and the last hit from anywhere. Try your best to land the middle hit as well, since this will double the damage of fire and it really quickly adds up over time. Lightning deals moderate damage and paralyzes the target, preventing them from acting if the debuff is successful. Gravity Well places a long-lasting AoE that continuously deals damage and pulls in smaller enemies. Tapping the button once will place it immediately in front of you rather than auto-targeting an enemy, so make sure you either lock on or hold and aim. Mystic Vortex instantly gives you 3 stacks, allowing you to immediately go into a fully charged, quick-casted Stargaze. Concentration places a circle on the ground that gives Io Stout Heart, which is basically super armor, and increases the charge speed of Stargaze. Because the Steady Focus Sigil gives Stout Heart while charging, and we have Quick Casting when following up a Mystic Vortex acquisition, I generally don't use this ability. Flower E7 is a massive nuke that drops 7 meteors on the target that deal AoE damage. At lower power levels, you can charge this ability to make it deal more damage, but later on you'll be able to tap the ability and still hit the damage cap. Healing Winds places a long-lasting AoE heal over time on the ground. One thing to note is that the visual of the spell is larger than the actual effective area, so make sure you're within where this arrow points on the circle to get the heal. With all the skills covered, here is the build that I recommend for general play. In fights where you don't care to paralyze the target, you can swap Lightning for Gravity Well. Io's Link Attack is a very quick ranged laser beam that additionally grants a Mystic Vortex stack, allowing you to immediately go into a quick cast. During Link time, you're granted max stacks of your Mystic Vortex at all times, along with the standard buffs, so you should be looking to quick cast as many Stargazes as possible, which generally ends up becoming Fire or Freeze into Stargaze over and over. If you don't have all of your Link time masteries yet, you might find that some of your skill cooldowns don't come up in time to use. If that happens, go ahead and use charged attacks to grant you your quick cast for your Stargazes. For your offensive masteries, you're going to want to pick up the Quick Cast mastery so that you can charge your abilities very quickly following skills and charged attacks. And then further down the line, you're going to want to pick up this Mystic Vortex enhancement so that you can get max stack stargazes during your link times over and over. And the only other minor nodes that I would say you should go for immediately are these faster cooldowns in link time nodes, so that you can machine gun your spells and rotate between them and stargaze in your link time. For the defensive tree, the only thing that you need to rush is the perfect dodge. And you can get perfect guard, but I wouldn't say it's a priority. For your weapon collection, I would say that you should go for the HP nodes in the Little Witch Scepter, which is the base weapon that you start with. And other than that, I would go for the crit damage nodes in the Colossus Kane Omega Tree. And then after that, you can fill them out at your own discretion, because you'll have to max them all anyway to get your Terminus weapon. For your overmasteries, make sure that you go for the normal attack damage cap up first, followed by your skill damage cap up, and then the rest are lower priority, but good ones are Skybound Art damage up, and the Skybound Art damage cap up, and the Chain Burst damage up. For weapon recommendations while leveling, I would say you should go for the Colossus Cane to get your crit chance capped out as soon as you can, and towards the end game, you can use whatever you'd like, but you're going to be going for the Terminus weapon, which means you'll max everything out anyway. For sigils, make sure you have some source of Stout Heart, either from Steady Focus or from the Stout Heart sigil in Sierra's shop. The standard endgame rules apply regarding maxing out your damage cap and hitting that cap consistently. Apart from that, we cap our crit with Lucky Charge, and we slot in War Elemental when we need, and max out Quick Charge with 2 sigil slots. If your sigil combinations allow, any extra slots you have should go to supplementary damage, or defensives if you want them. There's a ton of ways to build, and that's a large part of the fun of the game, so try things out and let me know if you find anything else that's interesting. Okay, now let's move on to 2 more advanced pieces of tech for you to try to elevate your gameplay. One of the ways to increase your DPS as EO is to get as much value out of Quick Charge as you can. This means casting a 1-bar Stargaze after every stack of Mystic Vortex, before casting the full 4-bar Stargaze. Done right, you should see a 10-15% increase in your overall DPS. Obviously, there will be scenarios where you don't want to do this, such as a tight damage window where it would prevent you from landing your final Stargaze, so don't consider it a rule, but just another tool in your arsenal. The other piece of tech isn't unique to EO, but is an important mechanic to understand in GBF Relink in order to skip phases. It's also a ton of fun to do. All bosses are different, but most bosses will enter Bloodthirst, the mode where they take reduced damage and do some annoying mechanics, shortly after entering Overdrive. However, if you break them before the Bloodthirst, this will cancel the Overdrive mode, and then the boss will have to rebuild their gauge before being able to enter Bloodthirst again. There are exceptions where some bosses will enter Bloodthirst out of drive, or will immediately do it again after getting up from break, but the vast majority follow this pattern. EO has Paralyze with Lightning, which means that right as the boss enters overdrive, we can paralyze them, then to do massive stagger damage with Flowery 7 and Fire to break the boss. Using this method to skip phases and coordinating CC with teammates is a ton of fun, so I definitely recommend giving it a try. And that's it for my EO guide. I'm constantly learning new things about every character and having a blast, and I hope you are too. I hope the guide was helpful. Let me know what you think about it, or if you find out any cool stuff, down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and stay healthy.